co-chairs of ASEAN-India, Eminent Persons Group, Ambassador Shyam, Saran, Pengiran, Datin, Paduka, Masrainah, Ahmad, Your Excellencies, distinguished flag officers, friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed an honor to be present in your midst and to be associated with the flagging off ceremony of the ship that is about to embark in my assessment on a historic voyage to retrace track over waters that our ancestors sailed, which have had, I believe, a profound effect not only on our histories but indeed on our destinies as well. It was in 92 that the government of India embarked upon its look east policy, both in economic and the political sense. As our Prime Minister has often said, it was about reaching out to our civilizational neighbors in Southeast Asia and East Asia. The trade between India and our ASEAN neighbors has crossed $50 billion mark, and our increasing economic interaction may well enable us to achieve the target of $70 billion in the current year. This voyage commemorates the 20th anniversary of the ASEAN-India Dialogue Partnership and the 10th anniversary of ASEAN-India Summit Level Partnership, as our multifaceted relationship grows from strength to strength. For both India and ASEAN nations, this modern relationship is a rediscovery of sorts. There is ample evidence that the ancient mariners, patronized by kings of great dynasties like the Kalingas, Cholas, Pallavas and the Zamorins, traversed across the Indian Ocean and Bay of Bengal, facilitating economic and cultural exchanges between India and Southeast Asia. President Sukarno of Indonesia had most graciously acknowledged this relationship and stated, I quote, "The culture we possess is steeped through and through with Indian influence," unquote. Equally strong has been the influence of Southeast Asia on the Indian civilization, as was acknowledged in 1996 by the then External Affairs Minister, Sri Inder Kumar Gujral, who later became the Prime Minister, to the ASEAN conference at Singapore. He had said, and I quote, "Merchants and traders linked us together for centuries as they ventured across the Indian Ocean and the Bay of Bengal. The footprints of Southeast Asia are seen in every aspect of the Indian ethos," unquote. In the recent times, our maritime interaction based on a cooperative approach has enabled us to address diverse challenges and harness the opportunities in the maritime domain. Regional initiatives such as IONS, RECAP, Mal Sindo, Milan, Eyes in the Sky, Indo-Thai Corpet, Indo-Corpet stand testimony to these efforts. I'm certain that such cooperation in maritime domain is only bound to increase further in the future. It was with a view to strengthening our historic bonds that our Honorable Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, had proposed at the 9th India-ASEAN Summit meet last year to send this fine three-masted bark on an expedition to the ASEAN countries along the route of the monsoon trade winds. Considering our growing maritime interaction, it is most appropriate that Sudarshini, the second sail training ship of the Indian Navy, should attempt to reinforce these historic maritime linkages. As the young lady sets sail out of Cochin Harbour today and makes her way towards the distant ports of ASEAN countries, She will recreate the voyages of ancient times and strengthen further our maritime bonds. During the next 6 months, a young and courageous crew would be exposed to the elements of nature and the challenges that the sea poses. I am happy to note that the numerous young trainees from countries being visited will also be embarking this fine sail ship during different legs of her voyage. I am certain that they would also benefit immensely from the experience. I am optimistic that this sailing expedition would bring our communities closer with better understanding of our traditional cultural and economic linkages, while sensitizing the people about the enormous opportunities that exist in this region. I would like to wish Sudarshini and her crew, in the traditional naval manner, fair winds, following seas, and plenty of water under her keel at all times. Shano Varuna and Jai Hind.